Hey everyone, Sean Savin Moo, and man, look at us. We're braving mosquito-infested areas so that we can bring to you the best quality golf instruction possible. Today, we're gonna be hitting punch shots.
Yeah.
And those punch shots are super primo important because you're gonna realize how centered you're gonna stay and how with the shot you're gonna stay. Your alignment, the direction of the initial ball flight, all of that stuff is going to improve greatly. All you need is an area like this in your neck of the woods to, with minus the mosquitoes, to really appreciate this. So stay tuned, you don't want to miss this show. But before we begin, we would love for you to subscribe to our channel, Mosquitoes and All.
Please leave a comment or question down below and give us a thumbs up.
And hit that bell so you never miss any videos.
Now, for all of you who have a tendency to hit the ball a little too high, when it comes to wedge play in the wind, that can be a little bit of a problem. So now you're exposing yourself to the elements and it's very difficult for you to stay with your target when that happens. So right out of the gate, if you look at, I'm trying to go to this yellow post, I can't fire this off. I got my 7-iron in my hands, and I'm gonna take it right out from the center of these trees here. You'll see how low this actually goes. So in order for me to get the ball to go lower, let's look at a couple of fundamentals. We need to play the ball further back in the stance, so it's at a point where we're hitting more downwards on the ball, but not down to the point where the roots and the planet are waiting for you. You want to feel like you can still get along the ground and into the direction that you want to start the ball. So really important. So when we play the ball further back in the stance, if we go with your normal grip and the hands are forward, you'll notice the face of the club is going to be a little too open. So what we need to do is we need to close the face. Now, this is not closing the face. This is just me changing the angle of my hands. Your hands and arms have a proper reset position in your machine. So the shoulders are actually a little forward on the rib cage, and notice how my hands are hanging to the inside. And what happens is if you do this to close the face, notice my right hand's on top, my left hand is underneath. Well, when the hands come back to normal, that's where they're going to bounce back to. And now I'm back to my, you know, neutral club face. If I bring my hands more forward, that face is way too open. So what we need to do is we need to let go of the club entirely, close the face, and then put the hands back on. So if you look, I'm closing it more. Notice my hands didn't change. I'm closing it more, my hands didn't change. I'm closing it more, so notice I just keep going around and around. That's why there's a round grip on the club. You just close the face, keep the same grip. Now when you play the ball further back in the stance, now we got a nice solid square face to go in the direction that we want to go. So, next what we need is an intermediate point. So when you're in the trees like this, there's always some wonderful different kinds of weeds. I got this tall one right here. I got this one over here. I want it no more than a foot in front of the ball so that I'm swinging through that particular weed toward the target. And so you're using the weed to align yourself, but you're also using that weed to deliver your action in that direction. And for those of you who have a tendency to be a little off in your alignment, the ones that are really to the right, if you're too far to the right, trust me, you'll feel those trees front and center. So then you say, okay, hang on. I want to feel like when I swing, so if you look at the blur of my club above the ball, notice the blur of the club is moving in the direction of this intermediate point. That's how I know that my action is ready to go to the target. Now, another important thing is that you're not just going out in between these trees. Once it's out there, you need to have a complete flight plan to know where you want this ball to end. So behind that yellow post, we got three flowery trees. I'm going to start it to the one on the right and draw it back to the one on the left. So I've got an intermediate point here that's going right toward the post. that tuft of grass right there, and I'm going to start it just a hair to the right of that and bring it back into my picture. So here we go. Excellent. So that started right on the line I wanted to, and it's drawing back not quite as much as I want to, but at least it's almost on the post. So that really gave me solid contact in that direction. So now, to, as a really good analogy to help you with that, you're going to go to an oldie but goodie video called Hammer Through, where we're using a door frame and we're squeezing a ball through the door frame into the direction that we want the ball to go. And that's a really, really solid analogy to keep that ball flighted low. So let's see what Moo's got for us.
I thought I was going first.
Yeah. So Moo likes those flowery trees behind that pin as well. All right, well, it started in the right direction, but it flared a little bit, right?
Yeah, so we're gonna pull the face.
Now, here's, you were talking about this just before.
Yeah.
Now, if you were playing hockey,
yeah,
and it's Stanley Cup time, our Canadians are right there in the finals, right?
Yeah.
So if I wanted to lift the ball into the branches, I would be doing this. So notice my hand on this side, the palm is facing down, and now I'm just flipping the puck right into the trees, and that would be over the glass, delay of game penalty, not a good thing.
Exactly.
So I want to keep the puck low, so I'm going to release the puck very low under the branches. In order for me to do that, if I go towards you, notice my lead hand now is under the stick.
Yeah.
So now when I release that, it keeps the puck nice and low, and now I can go into the net the way I want it to. So a good way to feel that, you have a really good drill that you like, right? It's the sword drill.
That's it.
So let's see you hold the club like a sword and give it a nice release. So do that toward the camera, Moo. Show them towards the camera, or towards me if you want to.
Oh,
yeah.
Towards the camera?
Yeah. So observe how the back of Moo's right hand is releasing toward the ground. Show us in slow motion, Moo.
Okay.
Coming through. Then what is it going to do? Yes. So when, exactly, so when the tip of the blade, right, of the sword releases and catches up to the hands, this hand's got to yield and allow it to come through.
That's right.
So if you do it with the left hand now, so notice as he's releasing that left hand towards you, see how the palm of the left hand is releasing toward the ground? And then we got this amazing release. Yes, and that's what flights the ball for you. And that, you get that for free with your human anatomy.
Yeah.
So we're letting it release in the direction that is just left of the post toward that flowery tree. That's got draw on it. Try a couple more.
Okay.
You just release that too much at the bottom.
Yeah.
So you want to feel like you're releasing it under the branches and out to the left of that post.
That's right.
All right. Oh, much better. Is that turning back to the right?
It stays
straight. No, I saw it. It had a nice little bounce to the left.
Yeah.
One more.
Okay.
You got this. Bingo. Wow, what a shot.
That's nice. Thanks, Sean.
Great work, man.
Appreciate
awesome.
It.
Sav, come on, let's see the greatness. Notice how much fun this practice is, right? Moo just hit a half dozen shots, and you get the feel of it very, very quickly. So you want it shooting out there, but not into the trees. And it's got to, you know, find a certain flight plan. So you're going with the same flight plan, Seth?
Yep.
Not bad. So I can see you're playing the ball right off your back foot.
Yeah, I could play a little less.
A little less back. That's it. Exactly. just back between center and the back foot is perfect. And that feels like it's a little more closed than usual.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Amazing. So one of the things that Savannah was struggling with in her swing, and you heard it enough times from me, watch that left foot, right? So the last thing I want to do is tell her about how her left foot is rolling out. I want to find something that she can focus on as far as the target's concerned and never have to worry about that left foot.
Yeah.
So if you make a practice swing in front of the camera here, do a backswing and stop and show them what was happening to the left foot, right? So it was rolling a little to the outside and the front of the foot was coming off the ground.
Yeah.
Now show me how you're gonna stay low beneath these trees. Fantastic. So we just put out this practice session on our premium channel from Face On and down the line. And one of the things that really took to her is the need to make the swing big went away.
Yeah.
And now all of a sudden she was staying so much more with the picture because the picture is so nicely framed. And because the picture was framed, she was able to stay with it. That foot stayed perfectly on the ground. Her head never moved off an iota from, you'll see a tree behind her, and your head doesn't move off the tree.
No.
And then it doesn't move into the tree on the way through either.
Nope.
So for all those of you who have a tendency to move forward in the ball, you get ahead of the golf ball. This is such an important drill for you to perform. So let's do one more to finish, Sav. Bring it home. So back off a little bit, get your intermediate point. Left tree to right tree. Amazing. Amazing. There you go. So have a look at these swings that we put together for you with Rapsodo, because Rapsodo actually worked here.
Yeah.
And it was able to track the ball between the trees. Really cool. You got to see this.